Good morning, guys. Now, today we will take some revision of chapter number 3, standard maths. Chapter number 3 is understanding quadrilaterals. So, first of all, students, I will teach you about what meaning of quadrilateral. So, simple students, quadrilateral means it has four closed sides. Means if there are four line segments and their ending points are joined to each other, that means closed, then we can say it is quadrilateral. Means four line segments in closed shape joined to each other, then we can say it is quadrilateral. So, simple definition of a quadrilateral, closed four sides, that means it is quadrilateral. So, and quadrilateral has four sides, four angles, four vertex and two diagonals, that means it is quadrilateral. Okay, so first of all, quadrilateral. Quadrilateral means this one type of quadrilateral. This one type of quadrilateral. So it has four sides. How many sides? Four sides. Okay, and four vertex. A, B, C, D. Four vertex. So, four vertices. Then, four angles. Angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D. Four angles. Four sides. So, into one to write the segment AB, segment ABC, segment CD, segment D. These four sides. These line segments, four vertex A, B, C, D is four vertex A, B, C, D, and four angles, angle A, angle B, angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D, these four angles, and two diagonals, this consecutive points. Not consecutive points, that means it is diagonals. So two diagonals. Two diagonals AC and BD. Is clear? This is the properties and definition of quadrilateral. So in short, we can say quadrilateral has four closed sides, four angles, and two diagonals, four vertex. That means we can say it is quadrilateral. Now, plane surface. So, paper is a model of plane surface. Our paper, not book paper. Paper is a model of plane surface. Plane surface means our paper, is our ball, is also plane surface. So, paper is or green board, or blackboard. Blackboard is a model of a plane surface. Now, plane curve, where we join a number of points with a lifting a pair of pencil pen on P. when we join a number of points without lifting a pen on paper, we get a plain curve. See, example, when we join a number of points without lifting a pencil, means without lifting a pencil we draw one finger in a, on a paper, that means we can say it is a plain curve. See, on this one, without lifting chalk, I draw this. Yes, this plane curve. This is a plane curve. Okay, this our plane surface. Plane surface, and without lifting a chalk, I draw this figure. So we can say this plane curve. Plane curve means that line segment. If we join on the line segment without lifting a pen or pencil, we can say this plane curve. Is it clear? And we can say it is simple closed curve, because this line segment, these lines. So simple closed curve. Simple closed curve. This simple closed curve. Why? Because we use here only line segment. So we can say simple closed curve. And we use here line segment. We don't need line segment. But if this figure, this. Okay, without lifting a chalk, I draw this figure. But we can see this simple closed curve. Why we can say this simple closed? This plane curve. This plane curve. Because here I have not used line segment. This curve. So we can say simple curve. Simple curve. But simple closed curve, that means there we use line segment. Means simple closed curve is line segment, and simple curve not use their line segment. Okay, so this is the difference between line segment and plane curve. Now next topic is diagonal. Diagonal means a diagonal is a line segment. Diagonal is a line segment. A diagonal is a line segment connecting two non-consecutive vertex. A diagonal is a line segment. A diagonal is a line segment connecting two non-consecutive vertex of a polygon. That means it is diagonal. See, let's do here one. Yes. This quadrilateral. In this quadrilateral, a diagonal is a line segment. That means we have to draw here line segment. A line segment connecting two non-consecutive, means consecutive means this point after this point after this point after this point after this point. So non-consecutive means we have to leave one next point. So if we will start from here, then we have to leave this point. Then this point will come, and we have to join these both. क्लियर, सेम कंसेप्ट. इफ यू वांट टू जॉइन दिस देन यू विल लीव दिस पॉइंट एंड जॉइन नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. यस दिस द ओके. सो डायगोनल इज अ लाइन सेगमेंट कनेक्टिंग टू नॉन कंसेक्यूटिव वर्टेक्स ऑफ अ पॉलीगन, दैट मींस इट इज डायगोनल. नाउ सी हियर, this interior part of a plane, this interior part, what? So we can say it is interior. It is interior. And this exterior. This exterior, this interior, inside of this figure, inside of this curve, that we can see this interior part, and outside of this curve, this all space means it is exterior. Now I will teach you about convex polygon. In this convex polygon, if diagonals are inside of that polygon, that means we can say this convex polygon. Is it clear? If in a figure, in a polygon, that diagonals are lying inside of that figure, that means we can say it is a convex polygon. Is it clear, beta? Once again, convex polygon, in a figure, diagonals are lying inside of that polygon, that means it is convex polygon. See this convex polygon. Let's see this convex polygon. See, diagonals are lying inside. These diagonals are lying inside. Yes, diagonals are lying inside. So we can say it is convex polygon. But if diagonals are lying outside of the figure, outside of a polygon, that means we can say it is concave polygon. What? Concave polygon. Convex polygon means diagonals are lying inside of a polygon, and concave polygon means diagonals are lying outside or inside, both sides. But you should not take inside. Inside means if any one diagonals is lying outside of a polygon, then we can say it is concave polygon. What? Concave polygon. See, let's draw here one figure. This is the concave polygon. So this concave polygon, this is figure of concave polygon. Is it clear? That means if a diagonals are lying inside of a polygon, that means it is convex polygon, and diagonals are lying outside of a figure, that means we can see this concave polygon. Is it clear, beta? Okay, see. So here, we can observe that this diagonal. Yes. See, this diagonal is lying outside of this figure. That means it is concave polygon. But in this case, diagonals are lying inside. So it is convex polygon. This concave polygon. Okay. Now we will take regular polygon. So is a regular polygon. Regular polygon. These all are theory. If you know this theory properly, then definitely you can do any sum easily, which is depending on this chapter. So here, regular polygon. Next topic we will take regular polygon. sentence is, it is rectangular polygon. See, let's do here one figure. This all sides are same. All sides are same. So we can see this regular polygon. Okay. Now irregular polygon. All sides are not same. Irregular polygon. Irregular polygon. All sides are not same. That means it is irregular polygon. Regular polygon means all sides are same. That means it is regular polygon. And all sides are not equal. So we can see this irregular polygon. Okay. Now let me start some important properties of angle sum property. Is it clear? Now some important formulas we will learn. See, important formulas of this chapter. There are few important formulas and you must know this formula properly. Okay, because in this is your basic concept, basic chapter. If you know this basic all concepts in your mind, then definitely you can solve any sum of this geometrical chapter. Important formulas. First, sum of interior angles of a triangle means three sides. Triangle has three sides and three angles, and interior angle sum we have to find. Then interior angle sum is always 180 degrees. The sum of interior angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. First formula. The sum of interior angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. Means three sides. How many sides? Three sides means triangles, and sum of all interior angle measurement is always 180 degrees. This first number formula. Okay, so triangle, interior triangle measurement is, the sum of interior triangle measurement is always 180 degrees. Now see, the sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral is always 360 degrees. Means quadrilateral has four sides and four angles. Okay. So triangle sum is 180 degrees and quadrilateral sum is 360 degrees. Is it clear? Simple concept. Triangle sum is always 180 degrees and quadrilateral sum is always 360 degrees. So triangle sum is 180 degrees. Second quadrilateral sum is 360 degrees. But if five sides given, five sides here, three sides means triangle, four sides means quadrilateral. But if five sides given, that means which type of that given? So if five sides, five close sides given of a polygon, that means we can say this pentagon. What pentagon? Pentagon has five sides and five angles. So it is pentagon. And we want to find sum of all interior angles of a pentagon. So we haven't that type of formula. So here particular one standard formula I will show you. See this very important formula. sides given, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, any side given, and you want to find interior angle sum, interior angle sums, then simply you use this formula there, then you can definitely find its sum of interior angles. Okay, so let's see, I show this formula. Now number 3, number of this number, first I will show you number of diagonals of, so first n sides sum, n sides sum of a polygon. N means n sides, means 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, whatever any size given, and you want to find sum of interior angle measurement. N sides, n sides sum of, sum of interior angles of a polygon. So simple, you use this formula here, n minus 2 multiply 1. Simple, n sides sum of interior angles of a polygon equal to n minus 2 multiply 1. See, how can we use this formula? See, let's give here one example. Suppose 3 sides sum is 180, 4 sides sum is 360 degrees, but if 5 sides means pentagon, 5 sides means pentagon, what pentagon, and we want to find its interior angle sum, then which formula we can use here? See, simple, sum of 5 sides polygon, sum of interior angles of a pentagon, sum of interior angles of a pentagon equal to, see this formula, n minus 2 multiply 180. N is size, 5 minus 2 multiply 180. 5 minus 2 is 3 multiply 180. 18 is 54. So 540 means sum of interior angles of pentagon is 540. So now let's take the second another one. Suppose 7 sides. So we can say this heptagon. 7 sides is heptagon, and you want to find sum of all interior angles measurements, n minus 2 multiply 1. N is 7 minus 2 multiply 1, 7 minus 4 5 multiply 1, 18 5 are 9, so 900. Now I hope you understood this formula. Means suppose here 9 sides, 10 sides given, means 10 means octagon, decagon, sorry, 10 sides means decagon. Decagon given, and you want to find sum of all interior angles of a decagon. So simple, use this one, n minus 2 multiply 180. N means 10 sides, 10 minus 2 multiply 180, 10 minus 2 8, 8 multiply 180, and multiplication, simply you can get it answer. Now next fourth number formula. If we want to find number of diagonals, नंबर ऑफ डायगोनल्स ऑफ एंड साइड्स, नंबर ऑफ डायगोनल्स ऑफ एंड साइड्स ऑफ अ रेगुलर पॉलीगॉन इक्वल, इज इक्वल, दैट मीन्स इफ any regular polygon given, any regular polygon given and we want to find how many diagonals are lying inside of that figure. So we can use this formula. Suppose in a quadrilateral, quadrilateral means four sides, four angles, four vertex and two diagonals, we know that. But in a quadrilateral there are four sides, four closed sides, but how many diagonals are lying inside? That figure we want to find. So we know there are two diagonals. But if suppose 10 sides polygon given, 10 sides means decagon. That means how many diagonals is lying there? We don't know. So how can we find that number of diagonals? So that time we can use this formula. So this is the particular formula to find number of diagonals. So number of diagonals of n sides of a regular polygon. So here formula n minus 1 upon 2 minus n. n minus 1 upon 2 minus n. This is the particular proper formula to find number of diagonals of a regular polygon. So here see. But this is very hard formula. So let's we convert this hard formula to simple. How can we convert this? It's very easy. For that we have to do simplification. Here, simplification. See, this first term and this our second term. This is our second term. Okay? So first we will take this to LCM. So simple, we will go in that side and multiplication with this n square minus n ones are n minus and 2 multiplication will be here 12 upon 1 lakh LCM. Once again I repeat this n multiplication with so n square minus n 12 upon 1 lakh LCM 2. So n square minus plus 2 plus 1 3n upon 2. Now from this both term we can observe n is common, so we can take n common, n square 1 n common, so 1 n remain, minus n common 3 remain upon 2. Yes, this is our final formula to find number of diagonals of a regular polygon. See, so number of diagonals of n sided of a regular polygon equal n minus 3 upon 2. See, so let's we use this take an example. Suppose quadrilateral. How many diagonals are lying in a quadrilateral? So we know that 2, but if we want to use this formula and prove that definitely it has 2 diagonal series. So I can write number of diagonals formula n into n minus 3 upon 2. This formula n into n minus 3 upon 2. N is quadrilateral has 4 sides. Yes, 4 sides we know. So in case of n we will put 4. N means 4 minus 3 upon 2. Yes, we can cut here over the downside. 2 2's are 4. This 2. And 4 minus 3 1. And 2 minus 2. Yes. So definitely a quadrilateral has 2 diagonals. But if 6 sides given means hexagon. See. How many sides? Hexagon. Hexagon means 6 sides. 6 sides given and we want to find its number of downs. So simple, number of downs equal to n into n minus 3 upon 2. Yes, this formula, n is 6, n is 6 minus 3 upon 2. 2 3 is 6, yes, 3, 6 minus 3, and 3 is 9. So, 9. So students, here we observe here two formulas are very important. Sum of all the interior angles of a polygon. So there is one formula, n minus 2 multiply 180. And second number formula, if you want to find number of diagonals of a regular polygon, so formula is n minus 3 divided by 2. This one. Okay, so you learn this four formula properly and by heart this all four formulas. Okay, thank you and have a nice day.